Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. The worldwide smartphone market grew more than 40% year-on-year, and Samsung overtook Apple as the number one handset maker. That's according to IDC, which can only estimate unit shipments since Samsung doesn't provide exact numbers. The race between Apple and Samsung remained tight during the first quarter. Propelling Samsung forward was the continued expansion of its Galaxy portfolio in nearly all directions, while the launch of the iPhone 4S in China helped boost Apple sales. Microsoft is working with developers to clean up apps in the Windows Phone marketplace that have racy or sexual content. In a blog post, it said it would enforce its sexual content guidelines more stringently. It will permit the content that you see on primetime TV or in the pages of a magazine swimsuit issue. It's also not banning sexual-related apps, rather suggesting that developers use silhouettes or drawings as the icon images. Because Microsoft wants mass adoption of Windows phones, it'll have to offer reassurances to parents that it's safe for their kids to play with a Windows phone without being exposed to racy content. Facebook added a new option to US and UK users this week, the opportunity to denote organ donation status on their profiles. Since adding the status in your profile doesn't make anything official, Facebook has also provided links to organ donation registries, and it seems to be working. The state of California saw a 1,400% jump in registrations on the day that Facebook added the new feature. Nokia plans to start shipping the PureView 808 later this month. That's a smartphone with a 41-megapixel camera. We first showed it to you in February at Mobile World Congress in Barcelona. The camera phone has a Carl Zeiss lens and runs Symbian. It'll be available first in India and Russia, and additional countries will be announced in the near future. Casio has released an experimental app for iPhones and iPads that encodes and sends data using colors. The app called Pika P Camera presents a set of icons which a user selects along with a short message. It then stores that information on a server and encodes a lookup code in the form of a flashing dot that appears on the screen. Multiple dots can be scanned in through the camera of separate devices using the same app. The dots are then replaced with a message and an icon chosen by each user. This can be captured in a photograph, which is then automatically sent back to everyone who showed their dots. Everything occurs without revealing any personal contact information, as the data is exchanged using only the flashing dots.
カシコ通信によって送っているのは簡単なIDを送っています。それをカメラがキャッチするとですね、カメラの中に映っているIDを拾って、クラウドサーバーに内容を問い合わせて、その絵を取ってきて画像をやるということをやっています。
Future versions of the app may be used to quickly exchange contact information. Most of us have heard of Groupon, but that's not the only social deal site out there. We had the chance to take a look at how a pizza chain uses Privy, an online service that allows businesses to offer promotions to existing customers. Crazy Doe's Pizza uses the service to offer deals to its customers through email blasts and on Facebook.
As far as revenue, it doesn't draw in thousands of people like the other sites, but it's our existing customers coming in, and they're happy because they're getting a reward. We have a huge redemption rate, which unlike other of the deals we've done in the past with other sites, the redemption rate's over 75%, which is amazing, because you want those people to come in as soon as possible, and then hopefully next month they'll buy the next deal we have out there.
Privy takes a 15% cut of whatever's sold, where competitors like Groupon take half. Privy's founder said that the company's mission is to unite consumers that are looking for a business, rather than people looking for a promotion. Fujitsu has developed a new system that allows standard mobile phone cameras to take 3D pictures. The company has produced a small attachment that fits over a phone's lens. The attachment uses a series of small mirrors to split an image or video recording into two parts. It then uploads this data to a server, which combines the two parts into a single 3D picture or video. Fujitsu is running a promotion on a Japanese website called Nifty, where it provides the mirrored lens attachment and server access free of charge. The promotion runs through the end of June. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Mark your calendars. Next week, I'll be in Austin, Texas for the Computer-Human Interaction Conference. Always a lot of interesting research and prototypes, so stay tuned. As we head out this week, we'll leave you with shots of the Olympic rings at Kew Garden. They're 50 meters long and can be seen from Heathrow's flight path. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next week from Texas.